In a sense, we were thinking, okay, we have 200 working PhD scientists here. They're researching all around the world. We have vast collections of specimens and artifacts. What can this be for kids?
Will this be an ongoing site or these one-off sites? But then we thought, we need this to be an ongoing brand.
We never wanted this thing to look like a science textbook.
10 years ago, the American Museum of Natural History launched a science website for kids. It's called OLogy.
When we launched something on the web 10 years ago, that was really kind of close to the beginning of the web for the world in terms of mass use.
But OLogy's rich content has kept kids coming back.
The premise is that science is inherently fun and the kids are curious about stuff around them.
No, you have to do the first one. Okay, they need to...
From quizzes to interviews and story galleries, OLogy continues creating content that engages kids.
You know, if we get an email from the scientist working on a particular piece on Friday at 5 o'clock, I mean, the thing doesn't go live until the science is right, you know, and this cannot be said for a good portion of kids' educational science content out there.
We're never trying to dumb down the content and make it look like it was a game or anything like that, but just really rich, colorful, fun.
And it's those features that help make the science accessible, including the OLogy cards feature.
They would be these fun, animated, colorful, essentially baseball cards about science topics, about the dinosaurs, about the scientists who look for them, about the places on Earth and in space where we do our science.
In the end, OLogy continues to teach kids science in a dynamic way.
If you look at the OLogy site today, there's ample opportunities to jump between different disciplines, to move between different content areas. And that's very important.
Or is that? That's 60 people too.